हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न अबाउट वन मोर मेटाबॉलिक डिसऑर्डर विच इज़ कॉल्ड हैज ऑस्टियोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा। सो वॉट इज़ दिस ऑस्टियोजेनेसिस इम्परफेक्टा? इट इज़ एक्चुअली ए स्केलेटल डिसप्लेशिया और हाइपोप्लेशिया सिंड्रोम। हियर देर इज़ स्केलेटल डिसप्लेशिया और हाइपोप्लेशिया सिंड्रोम। वॉट इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल हियर? हियर देर इज़ जेनेटिक डिफेक्ट। इन वॉट? इन टाइप 1 कोलेजन। There is genetic defect in type 1 collagen, both qualitatively and quantitatively. Okay, it is both autosomal recessive or autosomal dominant. It can be either autosomal recessive or autosomal dominant. See, this is how a healthy bone looks like. It has compact bone, and in the middle you have this spongy bone which is dense. Okay, it has dense, that is, it has many type 1 and type 1 collagen which are present in the type 1 collagenous cross links are present in the bone. If you see, this osteogenesis imperfecta is also called as brittle bone. In this brittle bone, see, the compact bone, it is loosely arranged. Why? Because there is defect in the type 1 collagen, and this defect in the type 1 collagen has resulted in loose attachment of the bone. Okay, this, the clinical features are here. If you see, there is increased tendency of fracture. It is osteogenesis imperfecta is associated with increased tendency for fractures. There are increased tendency for fractures. Then if you see here, there is increased tendency of fractures, but rate of fracture healing is completely normal. And if you see, these fractures are more common in the lower limb more than the upper limb. These fractures are more commonly seen in the lower limb more than upper limb. And you see multiple fractures which are repeatedly fractured. Okay, and see, these are the different fractures which are seen. And these fractures may extend to the growth line. If they extend into the growth line, sometimes these fractures may extend into the growth line, and in such cases it can cause growth arrest can occur. And there is also hyperlaxity of ligaments is noted, and also hypermobility of joints is also noted. There is hyperlaxity of ligaments and hypermobility of joints is also noted. The ligaments and joints are hypermobile. So this is the picture which is showing multiple fractures. See here, there is different fracture lines which you are seeing, and there are many in different healing stages. So all these with callus formation and different healing stages we have. So this is a child with osteogenesis imperfecta with multiple fractures, repeated fractures. So if you see here, this bent bone is because of repeated fracture which occurs in a child, hairline fractures. Next, if you see, what is this associated with? This osteogenesis imperfecta is associated with some deformities, like it is associated with malunion and deformities. It is associated with otopelvis. Okay, then although this disorder is rare, there is dislocation of patella can occur. Sometimes dislocation of patella can occur, dislocation of radial head can occur, and sometimes the skull may be soft and membranous. And there can be death can occur due to mainly intracranial hemorrhage and respiratory insufficiency. Intracranial hemorrhage and respiratory insufficiency can lead to the death of the patient. So you have malunion or any deformities, it is associated with otopelvis and dislocation of patella and radial head in severe cases. It can also leads to soft skull and membranous skull, and sometimes it leads to death. And if you see, we have one important thing is ocular involvement. So if you see the ocular involvement, what are you seeing here? Here there is blue colored sclera, right? So this is blue colored sclera. Here you can see it clearly, this blue colored sclera. Where do you see this blue colored sclera? Blue colored sclera is seen in osteogenesis imperfecta. And this ring like structure, are you able to see this? This ring like structure which you are seeing here. And this ring-like structure is given a name, which is called as, it is an arcus senilis, arcus juvenilis, because it is in children, it is arcus juvenilis or Saturn ring. It is called as arcus juvenilis or Saturn ring. Here there is retinal detachment or hyperopia is also associated. It is associated with retinal detachment and hyperopia. There is one more thing, which is auditory involvement is seen in 40-50% of babies. Okay, this can also lead to softening of bones. This can also lead to softening of bones, and this softening of bones causes nerve compression, leading to the nerve palsies also. It is sometimes associated with osteosclerosis also. Okay, so this is important thing. Next, if you see the investigations here, if you see serum calcium and serum phosphate levels are normal, the main investigation is if you do ALP, there is increased ALP. Why is there increased ALP? Because there are multiple fractures. In order to heal the bone, there is increased osteoblastic activity is present. Diagnosis, for diagnosis you will have to see family history, clinical examination and radiographic examination should be taken into account. Okay, then you will also have to see, do electrophoretic. You will also do electrophoretic analysis of type 1 collagen should also be done. Here you should even do electrophoretic analysis of type 1 collagen from fibroblasts cultured from skin biopsy specimen. This type 1 collagen, electrophoretic analysis of type 1 collagen from fibroblast cultured from skin biopsy specimen should also be done. And if you do this prenatal USG, in prenatal USG you will see multiple fractures are seen. And what is the treatment? The treatment which you do here is you can do Sikh kebab osteotomy, or we have Schofield Miller procedure. Sikh kebab osteotomy also called as Schofield Miller procedure. So this is about osteogenesis imperfecta. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. In the next class we will learn about Paget's disease. Thank you.